get to share this wonderful musical experience together. And I know, I'm sure you're just as excited as I am to be here. It's so good to see you again. It feels like it's been forever. It's so nice to see your faces and really to share our music with you. So thanks for being here. But before we get right to the music, I wanted to just welcome some special guests that are here with us tonight. First, we have our high school assistant principal, Andrew Prezone. And our superintendent, Dr. Fino Solano. We are all very appreciative of all the support throughout the district from the community, the Board of Education, and the administration that we're able to produce such amazing concerts like the one you're going to see tonight. So, before we start, I just wanted to focus your attention quickly in your program. Did I just drop it on the floor? Okay. This is my sheet right here about our Music Boosters Association. If you're not already a member, there is a QR code. You can just scan it and join. This is a dedicated group of parents who help support our students through scholarships, through programs, through general assistance throughout the years. They help provide equipment and supplies that are needed. I noticed some of the board members are in the audience today. Please feel free to speak with each other, or if you have any questions, you can ask me. But definitely check it out and be part of the process and helping our students. So without further ado, I'd like to introduce our concertmaster, Anderson Wong, and our ninth grade band and their director, Mr. Scott Stickley. Enjoy the concert.
Welcome to the Heritage Band Program. Thank you so, so much for taking your time out. I'm sure it was high on your priority list to see your son or daughter perform tonight. We haven't done this concert, the December band concert, in 2 years. Really amazing, right? Time is flying, but it seems so wonderful to be back and playing live music. That was Ray Vaughan Williams, a very important British composer, who took some songs that he heard everyone singing in his environment in England and set them to music, and that's a wonderful arrangement by Ed Huppertman. And the next piece we'd like to play is actually it's probably too dark for me, but it's really a piece that we did a couple years ago, A Solitary Wish, by a wonderful composer named Brian Balmages, who was out shopping one day during the holidays, and he encountered a homeless person. And, you know, at first he kind of wasn't sure how to really embrace this person, but he saw that people were just kind of passing him by, this person outside the store, and he decided to have a dialogue and find out really what was his needs and what did he need and what was the issue that he really had. He really spoke candidly about what he needed. And so from that time, you know, he really not only gave him something, but he really, really supported. And he responded with this piece that was really written for many, many programs around the nation. So this is a consortium piece that was written. And so many, many band programs were involved in the writing of this piece. It's only about 4 years old, A Solitary Wish. And what you'll hear at the beginning is the students are talking like they're in a mall, right? And then you hear like this little bell that does carol of bells. You know the carol of bells, of course? You hear that? And then it's juxtaposed with What Child Is This? Rain Sleep. So you hear these two melodies drawn throughout this whole piece. There's a couple of big, huge, really big spots in the middle, and then it goes to a little chamber music group and kind of ends very solitary like it did. But they think with a lot of hope that together we can really, really have a victorious world. So anyway, I hope you enjoy Solitary Wish by Brian Balmages. Thank you. might be a contraband tradition, that piece, but I think it's so wonderful and it teaches so many things. Before I let you play our last piece, I'd just like to say that it's such a great pleasure for me to work in the community for so many years that so much believes in music. And I think it's interesting in band music is that there's no lyrics in band music, right? So what that does is I think it emotionally grounds students in a different way than if there was lyrics. And I love lyrics. My brother is actually a songwriter, but without the lyrics, sometimes it takes the imagination another place and it takes the emotion in another place and really grounds students. I find music students to be very grounded. It's wonderful to work with your talented son or daughter. Thank you for all the lessons and the continual, you know, hey, did you practice? We have something in common, as I might have mentioned to some of you. I have a freshman in high school right now. She plays the viola. And now I understand. Anyway, we'd like to finish our set with Appalachian. I want to get the title right. Appalachian Air. This is about Song from the Wayfarer, which is a song that, it's an Irish melody that used to be, well, I'm sure it still is, sung in the Appalachians. And, you know, it's a kind of a wonderful melody that starts with, even if your life's in a little bit of woe, if you sing this song, you will see hope, and down the road, you'll see victory. So it's a really wonderful piece. And Nathan Doherty, I love this writer. He writes wonderful percussionists. We have a wonderful percussion section. Stick around, because we're going to do a finale with this group. They're going to show you what stereo looks like, right? Stereo DNA. So we're going to do that later. So stick around for a wonderful finale. I will bring the house lights up for that. And we're going to finish our little set with Appalachian Air by Nathan Doherty.
Thank you. And I sent a microphone.
Say your last name, Mark. Say your last name. I will be. I'm not. Admar, when I announce you, stand up and take a little bow.
Is this a microphone?
Don't worry about it. Huh? Is it uncomfortable for you? Welcome back. I'd like to introduce the concert master for the Symphony Band, Admar Palladini.
Thank you.
challenge for this group, and I put it to them, was that the whole time, all that fast, I'm conducting in one. So they have to control that tempo. Empty control, they did. This next piece we'd like to do by Eric Whitaker, who's a wonderful choral composer, based on the Seal Lullaby of Rudolf Kipling. And what happened with this young man is as he was coming up the ranks as a composer, now he's known everywhere worldwide as a choral composer, but as he was coming up the ranks, he worked with Schwartz, a famous Broadway composer, and he recommended to Disney, and Disney wanted to do an animation to Rudolf Kipling's Seal, the White Seal. And he was so excited, so he wrote this piece, and his wife helped him, and he sent it off to Disney. Never heard from him. He was really concerned, as he would be, because it's a big break. Finally, called him up and said, "No, we're not doing it. We're going to do Kung Fu Panda instead." So he was so heartbroken, because at that time he had a small child. So he wrote it. He kept the melody in his heart, and he would sing it to his child and get them to go to bed. So it's a really staple in the choral world. And Mr. Ambrose actually transcribes it for band. So we're going to play it for you now. You'll hear the melody about 12 bars in. The first part is just the introduction, and it kind of gets weaved all the way through by Mr. Ambrose in this wonderful arrangement, The Seal Lullaby by Eric Whitaker.
Thank you.
finish our portion with the Arabian dances. The piece is about 7-8 minutes long. It features a big percussion feature in the middle. And it starts off very, it's a landscape. So a lot of times the composers want to write a landscape, they kind of go like this, and then suddenly it just becomes very dynamic, and you feel like suddenly you've seen some large mountain. And there are mountains in the desert, so it kind of goes this, and then it goes like that, and then there's a celebration in the middle that features the band in the percussion section before it ends very majestically with a very vibrant vivo at the end. So thank you so much. Stick around for the sleigh ride. It's an over 50-year tradition in Paris to play the sleigh ride, so stick around for it. It should be wonderful. Wonderful way to end our concert. So without any further ado, the Symphony Band with Fireball Mages are ready to play. can we just kind of bring the house back up? There you go. So we can see everybody. So the Heritage Fan Program, long before I came, the tradition of the December concert is always the place later on. This is a wonderful piece of music by Leroy Anderson. Leroy Anderson wrote a lot of popular symphonic music in the mid-century. He was inspired by Currier and Ives. Have you seen those pictures of the sleigh ride? He was inspired by those. So we're going to play this for you today. We're going to bring out our freshman concert band. There's the A side and the B side on its way. So just give us a minute. I'd also like to thank my colleagues, Ms. Burke, our street high school student orchestra teacher, Marvin Johnson, and Alicia Brown, our wonderful middle school band director, a long friend. Also, Mr. Keenan, Mr. Arnold, Mr. Brazone, thank you so much for supporting our band concert tonight. Yeah, you can come a little closer. You guys come a little closer. Once again, thank you so much for coming. On behalf of the Harris Music Program and